Hey, in this video, we'll discuss about provider or services in NestJS. What is dependency injection and what all scope NestJS provides us while doing the dependency injection. We're going to see all that in this video. Hi everyone, this is Subrat and you are watching Fun and Futuristic. So on this channel, we'll make video like this, which is related to programming and web development. So please consider subscribing and hit the bell icon if you haven't yet. So what is a provider? Provider, as name says, is provide some functionality to some other things. Like it provide a functionality to your controller in the sense of, I'm saying for the Nest. It provide a functionality to other providers or other services. That's why the name is provider. In Nest, we call it as services, similar to Angular. Similarly, Nest also has services or providers, which is also injectable. So the scope of the provider is little different in Nest and in Angular. And if you are not from Angular and if you don't know anything about Angular, then think like the service or a provider in Nest is just a place where you can write your business logic or where you should write your business logic, and that provider can be injected in multiple places. So we'll go to the code now, and in our last video we have discussed about controllers, and if you haven't watched the video or you don't know what a controller is, please go ahead and watch that video. I will link them in the card. So here, if you see in our controller, we are using our app service, and app service is a provider or it's a service which we provide to different modules. So it's just a class which gives you ability to do business logic. And to create a provider or to create a service like Angular, Nest CLI gives us a command. Nest generate service. So G for generate, S for service, and you can write car. So for now, I'm just writing car. And it will create a folder with the service and the spec file in it. So if you go here, so you have a car service, it's just an injectable file, and we have a spec for it. And this car service is now provided inside our app module. And this car service can be used in multiple modules. In those scenario, our scopes comes into the picture. So before explaining scope, I would like to explain about what is dependency injection. So when you pass something in the constructor, in the background, it's injected to your app controller. So before it's got injected, what happens is when you start your application, so your app screen through all the injectable decorator. And if it founds it, it registers them and create an instance of it according to the scope. So by default, the scope is default. So we have three scope and I'm going to explain. So by default scope is the singleton, means only one instance of your app service will be created. So in this scenario, when we have created a cat service, whenever we'll start our application, only one instance will be created, and we can pass that instance to various modules. So here we have only one module, but you can pass this instance to various module, and the same object will be passed across your application. So that's the default scope of injection in Nest. So now we'll see what is dependency injection. Here I have three boxes which represent three modules, and we'll create one box which represents our services. Let's suppose S1, and another box here which will represent our service 2. And first of all, dependency injection is a patent which comes from inversion of control. And if you want to know more about them, I will link some articles or I will link some blog post in the description below so that you can go and read about them. Think like you are segregating your dependencies from your controller. In our scenario, controller and services. So now your controller is not much dependent on the business logic, what happening inside in your services. What you are doing is you are just injecting them and calling it and hoping that method will do its work and return me the result what I want from a controller point of view. Your application is decoupled. Now your controller can have multiple services injected, and that can do multiple calls and send data to your client as per the requirement. So coming back to the dependency injections and what the scope Nest provides here, by default, Nest injection is singleton. When we start our application, what will happen is a virtual memory will be created, and here S1 and S2 will be registered as a singleton instance. And whenever your module, if your module is eagerly loaded, that means for this kind of scenario, you are loading the module eagerly, means on start of the application itself, and you are providing your services eagerly also. So that means your module will be provided by S1 or S2. Suppose these two modules are eagerly loaded. So I will just write eagerly here. And suppose we are loading this module lazily. And whenever it comes and whenever you want to load this module, then it will going to get the same instance as these two modules got. So suppose you have instantiated some variable inside it and you have changed it with some operations or some time bound operation or some time you are adding it or something which is really which need to be passed across the module, then this service will going to help you, because by default your injection will happen as a singleton, and that's why single instance will be passed to all the modules. So as you are discussing about singleton, if you go to our code support car service here, so here you can pass scope. And Nest provides us three scope. Default one, what we just saw, singleton. Singleton through a whole application. And the second one is request. And the third one is transient. And if you just go and read the description here, it says that a new instance is instantiated for each request processing pipeline. And I will explain what that means. Now, if you go for request scope, then what will happen? What will change in this scenario? Creation of this green box means creation of your object will going to change. So what the request scope means here? So whenever you got a request from your client, maybe a get call from a browser, then at that time, the green box, you remember? At that time, this will be created. So I will just add a dotted line here. At that time, this green box will be created for each request. And inside that, your S1 and S2 will be added. And for the whole request response, like till you send a response back, so for the whole cycle, a single instance will be passed to all your modules. Okay, so module means inside module, you can also use other services and other controllers. So that's the basic difference between a singleton and a request scope. And now we'll see what the scope transient means. So if I just change this to transient, and it says that each private instance will be created. That means it doesn't care about the user. It doesn't care about your request. For a scenario, inside this module, you have suppose three controller, and similarly for this module, you have some controller. And in this controller, you are injecting or instantiating your services. So for example, from this controller, so suppose this is C1, from C1, we are instantiating or injecting our service 1, which has this scope, transient scope. So for that, whenever your controller will be loaded, so whenever your controller get instantiated, it will going to call your service. And at that time, one service instance will be created, like S1, and it will be assigned to a controller. Suppose your controller to call S1 is using S1, it will have a separate S1 service. That means whenever it got instantiated or whenever it got called, one new instance will be created. These are the three scopes what Nest provides. But if you are not sure about you should use a request scope or a transient scope, means if you don't have a solid scenario that you should use a request scope or a transient scope, then you should not add any scope at all. Means, or you can add scope as default, but it doesn't make sense. And now we'll see what are the ways we can inject our services to our controller or to other services. So here, you, as you can see, you have like a private read-only app service, which we have injected through our constructor. But it's also possible to inject through your property, means as a property field, car service. And for this, you need to give @inject. And it's from Nest command. And this will going to inject your car service to your app controller. Now, suppose you don't need app service, or you can also do the same for app service and you don't want a constructor injection. And it's debatable which one is good. Some says constructor injection is good. Some says property injection is good. It depends on you. So what happens behind the scene is similar. You already have an instance of your service. You are just getting an instance of that being injected to your controller. So in this case, controller. So suppose you are adding the same in a service. And if I'll go and add it here, then it will also going to work. Now I can access my car service. So that's how easy it is to access or to inject a service in your Nest application. NestJS also provides us to give an optional injection for your service. So what is optional and why? It provides as a separate parameter each. Suppose in this scenario, whenever our app controller will be created, our app service need to be resolved. Means your instance of your app service should be available. It should not be null. Else it will going to throw you an error. But if you pass a optional parameter, and what it will do, it is optional now. So if your app service has not been instantiated yet, or you are going to decide in a runtime. So suppose here you have already defined our app service. Suppose it's a generic type and you are passing that type like this. You have a generic class and you are passing that type. Then this will be decided in compile time. Then you can pass an optional parameter here. And you can also create a custom service to do some custom tasks. And that we're going to see in our future videos. And if you know Angular, then here also we have use values, use factories, and use classes. And we're going to cover all in our future videos. And those will be helpful in multiple scenarios. So please do subscribe to the channel so that you will not miss those videos. So that's all for today. Today we saw what is a service or what is a provider is, what is dependency injection, and how Nest handles it by providing different scopes, and how you can inject your services to your controller or to different another service by using constructor injection or property injection. So please hit the like button if you like the video till now. Please do subscribe to the channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you will not miss future videos. Please do share this video among your friends, family, colleagues, and let them know how they can use the services. We're going to meet in the next video. Till then, stay happy. Bye-bye.